Emmanuel, God is with us. Emmanuel, God is with us. I got you where I want you, in my garden. And I'm going to share a little gardener's tip with you with my veil on. So let us get nice and intimate here. I will uncover myself and share this intimate gardener's secret for you. I was just thinking about it and thinking about it. And is anybody else out there having this kind of seed hoarding, collecting, kind of, if I want this seed in the next 5 years, I must get it as soon as I possibly can kind of feeling? And I know some people are making fun of me, thinking, you know, you never were like that before. Well, you guys, a lot of the things that I wanted to plant this year, first of all, I didn't get to plant them. I had to pick all over again. When this quarantine happened, the seed houses shut down. I couldn't buy plants at the big box store because they were closed. And if they were open, they weren't selling plants. So maybe I'm a little traumatized. And it has resulted in a new form of hoarding. But I'm not willing to call this an illness because everything I purchased, I have planted. I have had the opportunity to buy seeds that I could succession plant. I have used up hundreds of seed. I have ate hundreds of fruits and vegetables. And then some seed were hard, and it took like maybe 50 tries for me to finally get them to germinate and grow. I had to, you know, practice on a lot of seeds, didn't know. Some things they need a cold period. I don't have any frost in my area that's enough for things. So I had to go through things that wouldn't germinate because I didn't have a cold period. Some things only will germinate in the heat. So when you buy seed, a lot of the information that you need on how to grow that seed is not on the package. And even me who do seed videos, if you don't listen carefully or look at what time of year I'm planting it, you're going to make a lot of mistakes with seed. So you're going to need a lot of seed. You know, you're going to have to try and try again until you learn how to grow it. And once you master how to grow a particular seed, you can always go back and do that over and over again. You have unlocked that box for that seed. You've learned how to give it what it needs. But in order to go through this process, you gotta kiss a lot of frogs to get that prince. You gotta kiss a lot of frogs, you know. And this year, the backup of going into the big box and buying plants that have already started wasn't there. And they just went, even in what they had, it was limited. So if you get to crunch time, maybe you bought the seed that you wanted, and a rodent ate it because you're rich enough to have a greenhouse, so you went into your nice air-conditioned house, goody for you. And while you were in that air-conditioned house, that little rodent went into your greenhouse buffet, is what the rodents call your greenhouse. They call it the buffet. Ate all your seeds, and then for dessert, ate seedlings. It happens, you know. A lot of bugs like sprouts just as much as we do. A lot of animals like sprouts. We're always talking about how much nutrition is in a sprout. Well, there's creatures out there that need to be nourished just as well as we do. God loves them too. And their buffet is called your greenhouse. So, should you run into that situation, what do you do? It's crunch time, you know. As I told you, seeds are very meticulous. I don't care what they say about, oh, just put it in your room and, you know, get a heat mat. Those seeds have a calendar in them, and they defy all circumstances. They know how much light there is or the lack thereof, and they will fold their wings and go back home to glory if you try to grow them at the wrong time, okay? And you don't beat yourself up. Hang in there. You can do it. I have become quite a seed grower, but there are still a lot of seeds that are defying me. Some seeds just, you know, they stay viable and they lurk in the darkness waiting for their moment. And as soon as I think that soil is just soil and dirt and put it in my garden, they sprout up as a weed someplace and I don't recognize them. Because, you know, that's another thing. You need to know what you're trying to grow so that you can know when God has blessed you, you know. So, suffice it to say, there are a few seed houses that in crunch time will get your seeds to you faster than any other. I would say number one on my list is Rare Seeds. They ship out in 1 or 2 days normally. And depending on how far you are away, you usually get your seeds within a week. So if you want, if you find that you need an emergency seed and they have it, they will get it shipped to you. And also, since they don't charge shipping, if you only need a few because it's an emergency, you can do it that way. Another seed house that is really quick is called Botanical Interest. Every purchase I made for them, they shipped it in 1 or 2 days. They get that box ready to go and it's out the door to you in no time at all. So I would highly recommend any emergencies, Botanical Interest, and Rare Seeds. Now, a third seed house that is really, really quick normally and may still be quick, and they are the cheapest seed house you can get seeds from, is called Little Shop of Seeds. And it's owned by Practice YouTube channel. His name is Ray. He owns that seed house. And he normally gets seeds out with a 1 day turnaround. But as of late, he has a little message saying that it'll take 2 or 3 days for him to get your seeds out, which is still quick. So you'll still get your seeds in time for this season. He's quick. He's really on the shipping game. He gets the stuff shipped to you in no time flat. And he's been consistent with that during this quarantine period. And I think things should have probably loosened up a little bit for him, because I think not as many people have fall gardens. But the thing about fall gardens, you guys, it's crunch time. You know, you're dealing with old man winter here. You gotta beat him. You can't be late to this party. 1 or 2 weeks can make a big difference right now. So those are the seed houses that I know can do it for you because I shop from them. I also watch a YouTube channel called Haas Tools. And I believe Haas Tools has talked about having a quick turnaround and getting your seeds to you quickly too. The reason why I'm mentioning all these different seed houses is because, depending on where you live, it can make a difference. Oh, and I forgot one. Seeds Now. They are another house that is quite cheap. Their seeds are 99 cents normally. A lot of them are now $2, but still relatively reasonable price. They usually get their seeds shipped quickly, but their shipping system is slower. So it takes about a week and a half for me to get seeds from them, and I could drive to them. They're about 45 minutes from me, but it takes 45 minutes to get seeds from them. I mean, it takes a week and a half to get seeds from them. They'll ship it right away, but they have a really lousy operations program where the seeds will just sit there ready to be shipped for a period of time in their store. And it takes a week and a half for them to get it 45 minutes across town. If they got it to the post office that same day, because I'm 45 minutes away, I could get the seeds the next day. If they ship Friday evening, I could get it Saturday morning, because the post office is efficient like that, you know? So, but they're still relatively quick and their seeds are $1, you know? So Ray's seeds at the Little Shop of Seed is 55 cents, but you have to pay like $5 shipping for his. Seeds Now, shipping, you know, they have coupons all the time. And if you go to one of my old haul videos, you'll see a 20% off coupon if you can't find any other coupons. So they're really cheap, and their shipping is usually pretty cheap too. Shipping's rare seed shipping is free, but their seeds are $3 or $4, up to $5 a pack. I paid for seeds from them because they have rare seeds. So I just wanted to give you this information. If it's last minute, you're like, I got to get those seeds this week, you know, or I got to get those seeds by next week, or how long is it going to take, you know, these are the seed houses that I know to be pretty efficient from my own personal experience. And with the Haas tool, just from what they say on their channel, I believe them. So you can check their website, because it is a situation with quarantine and more people are feeling anxious about seeds like me. Check their website. See if they are still able to give you a quick turnaround on the seeds, you know? And pick a seed house that's relatively close to you. Usually that should be the fastest. But like I told you, I get seeds faster from rare seeds and botanical interest than I do from a seed house that I could drive to. So that's my experience. This is my honest experience, what I've gone through, what I've heard about. And I just thought some of you may be going through some seed tragedies. Maybe you blew the wad, planted them all wrong season. Now you find out that was a cold season or a hot season, or takes 30 days to germinate and this, that, and the other. It made some seed mistakes, you know, all kinds of stuff. These are seeds, you know, these are infants, they're tender. This is where you go in crunch time. Thank you for watching this video. Appreciate that. Maybe, you know, it might offer you a little respite from the weariness of the world right now. You know, maybe. I could only hope. Jesus loves you, and I love you with all the Jesus in me. Be blessed, beautiful.